Hey guys, so as you know, I am in Cape Town, South Africa right now. So to start off this vlog on week 25 of the year, I'm going to first show you my view from my room. So this is the view from my room. We are staying in Hout Bay, Cape Town. You can see the waves breaking right there. That's what you get on one side. Over there, it's like a town. With like a nightlife and stuff, but we're mostly staying here for most of the day. It's absolutely unbelievably gorgeous. So this is where I am staying. I have a pretty nice setup here with my bed and my bathroom, my closet and stuff, and then right around here is the view, the little patio. Yeah, I wanted to show you guys where I'm living for these 2 weeks and what's up. Oopsies, I just broke my bed a little bit. Since we last spoke, I arrived in Africa and the first girls I met were named Alexis and Shantae. They are seniors at the University of Kentucky and they actually ended up being my roommates here. They're very southern and very sweet. So we came back and had dinner with everyone and turns out I'm like one of the youngest people here, if not the youngest. And there are a couple 20-year-olds, Angela and Rachel, and I think other 20-year-olds too, but those are the two that I'm closest with. And then while I'm talking about everyone, my other two roommates are Kate and Haley. Kate, I know, is getting her master's right now, and Haley, I think, just graduated and is moving to Nevada. So they're all at very different stages of their lives. Like, compared to them, I'm actually a child. But that's kind of nice. Yeah, we also have culture coaches here who are people who are from the nearby township, which is called Imizuma. There's no U in it. Okay, let me Google it. Imizamayetu. They're here because we are working with the children from that community. So they help us with the language, which is Xhosa, which we are learning today. We have a lesson today. They showed us around. We walked around with the culture coach Lelo the other day, and then they just know, you know, they know the area. So it's nice to have them around. But they're young and they're living with us and they're hanging out with us. So it's like not like they're unapproachable or scary to talk to. We went out for drinks at this place called Pakalolo, which is a bar that's like literally 50 feet from my front door. It's literally a 2-minute walk from sitting at the bar to sitting in my bed, and it's so nice. Then on Tuesday, we started with orientation, which was our health director, Christina, telling us what the program is about, why we're doing it, what's going on. I'm gonna make another vlog where I talk about like One Heart Source and this trip and all the things we did. Later, we went on a walk through Imizamayetu. It was very eye-opening. So many of them live in such extreme poverty like I've never seen before. People here like share communal toilets and share communal drinking water and have a limited amount of electricity that they can buy hardly anything, and a lot of them have roofs that leak and not even leak, but like don't provide any protection from the elements and no heat, no washing machine, no anything. I felt bad for even like having my phone. I lost my debit card during the walk. I realized that it wasn't in my pocket. It was at home, it was fine, but while I was walking through, I was not at all panicked about losing my debit card because I was like, that's so unimportant. Like, I'll call and have it canceled and I'll get a new one in no time. But these people, like, don't have houses. There are babies everywhere with young mothers. There are a million preschools because of the high teen pregnancy rate here. And there's just all the kids are so happy. Like, it's unreal compared to the kids at camp. Or the kids I work with Bruinlights, or like CYT kids even, these kids are just like always smiling, always energetic, always excited to see us. Like, I don't know what it is. It's something in the water, I guess. There's also just such a sense of community within them. And everyone's friends and everyone's family and everyone is hanging out, drinking. I met my children on Tuesday, the kids that I am tutoring. Their names are Yiva and Lihle. Yiva's a girl and Lihle's a boy, and they are so cute. Yiva is so talkative. She is out there. She is smart. She is like a little spitfire. She's like very, very energetic, and one of probably the most talkative and friendly people I've met. She's also brilliant. Like, this girl. She's 10, and she's so smart. And then Lihle is a shy little boy. He's like 10. And, or wait, I think he's 11. And he doesn't, like, speak English as well as Yiva does. But I'll post a video of what he is like a little bit later. You guys are gonna love him. Came back and we went to get like chocolate cake and dessert at this Italian place called Posticino's that is right next to Pocololo. It was very cold that night though. Oh my gosh. I thought I was going to freeze my butt off. But it's so cold here. It's winter. It's freezing. Like right now I'm wearing tights, a skirt, a long sleeve shirt, and a sweater and I'm okay. But I'm inside. Like outside or at night. It's unbelievably cold. Wednesday, we went to a health clinic and helped deliver medication, condoms, and like services like washing or ointment, things that people in the community need for those who are either too old or disabled so they can't walk to the clinic themselves. So there's a group of women that go out into the township and do like house visits. So we went with them. And I was with Rachel, Keely, and Jerry. And Jerry and I actually like gave a guy a bath together, and we were with Riri too. We kind of just provided just like company and a little bit of healthcare, and it was so cool to see. Like, I love that that happens every day. I went to my lesson, which was a little bit painful because it was my first day actually teaching the two of them together. And they learn very differently, so it was hard for me the first day to like get a hold of their learning style. And then we went to Pocololo again that night, and I had sex on the beach for the first time. That was fun. And then Thursday we woke up and we had a dialogue about optimism and pessimism, and how when it comes to a global perspective, people are very pessimistic about things like education and healthcare and the overall like standard of living in the world, and how it's actually a lot better than a lot of people think it is, because there are so many like developed countries and so many positive things that are happening in the world, so much progress that is being made thanks to technology and thanks to philanthropy and stuff like that, and that is actually happening. And just because the media only covers negative things, it's very easy to like forget that kind of thing, but it is. Positive things are present, and we are one of them. Like, we, One Heart Source is coming and educating these children every day. They don't need to be doing that, but they are, and it's helping these mostly girls. It's helping mostly young girls who want to become doctors, which is... And then we went to school, and I was really nervous about teaching them because the first day was really tough, but the second day actually went very well. And then we had a wine night at home with my roommates, and some culture coaches came over and we played King's Cup, and it was really cool. Alexis got super drunk. It was really fun. On Friday, we had a dialogue about AIDS, which was super informative. And I got to know more about the origins of One Heart Source, which again, I will talk about later. We went to the University of the Western Cape with the kids, and I'm pretty sure both my kids are like pretty popular. Like, they have a lot of friends, and it's cool to see them in their natural environment. It also like made me think about what I would be like as a mom, because like I care about these kids so much, and I was like, yeah, go off, like do your own thing, like have fun, and I hope I'm like that as a mom too. It was also interesting that even at the University of the Western Cape in Africa, I felt so comfortable on a university campus. Eva, I cannot wait for her to go to college. Like, she is going to go. I have no doubt about it in my mind. Like, she's so smart. Lihle probably too. It was really cool to like see them in a college setting. Then we went to the market, which was a conglomeration of a bunch of vendors and artisans and cooks and pastry chefs and people just like, you know, selling their stuff at Help Bay. And it was so immersive. Like, it was Awesome. It was kind of geared toward tourists, you could tell, but then at the back it was like there was music and food and dancing, or not dancing, and drinks. And that was just like a lo like locals could hang out there easily. I hung out most with Rachel and Angela that night, but also Kristen and Kate, and it was, yeah, that was like one of the most fun things, just walking around and seeing all the different things that they make here and food as well. Like, it was cool. Also, the band was like three old guys. The drummer was literally 70 years old, and I was like, this is the coolest thing ever. On Saturday, I woke up at 5 a.m. to go on a safari, and it was freezing, but it was worth it because we all like bonded a lot that day, and like the safari itself was sick. Really cool. It was, yeah, like we all, I feel like, got a lot closer. We went on the actual safari after we got free coffee and cookies. And the views to the safari were unreal. This entire continent is so freaking beautiful. Even like the townships and the super poor parts overlook like beautiful areas. Blows my mind. Yeah, so the group was Alexis and Shantae, and then Kate and Haley, and then Angela, Kristen, and Rachel. They're all very genuine and sweet and funny and smart and easy to be around, so I am very glad that I met them here. We went to Postuccino's for dinner, and I got pizza and a glass of wine, and we actually met some locals of Joburg, which is like Johannesburg, and they talked to us for like an hour. One of the girls was like really nice. One of the guys, I think he was like making fun of me the whole time because I had an American accent, and I was like, yeah, I do. But the girl was like really sweet, and we talked about, you know, just like shot the breeze and got to know a local, and I thought that was really fun. Everyone here is so beautiful. But lastly, on Sunday, I got up and went on a Cape tour with Angela and Kate, and we went to Simonstown and saw the penguins, then biked through a national park and had lunch, then went to the Cape of Good Hope and Cape Point. I will show you all of those in the other vlog that I'll be posting next week. And we went to Kloof Street, and went to a bar restaurant called Hudson's, and I got probably the best burger I've ever had in my life. It was ostrich meat, and it had like onion rings on it and like barbecue. I can't even explain it. Like, it was so good. So yes, I came back very satisfied and tired, and our power went out that night. LOL, that was funny. But other than that, it was a great night and everything went smoothly. I just went to bed. So that was my week. It's actually currently Tuesday here. So sorry that I'm posting this so late. I probably won't even edit this till tonight, so it'll be like maybe Tuesday morning by the time this is up, but I think I get a pass because I am in Africa. So I will talk to you guys all next week. Thanks for watching. Oh, and I like interviewed my roommates last night. So I will see you guys later.
Hey guys, so these are my friends. I'm gonna go around,
Hey.
everyone, introduce yourselves.
I'm Alexis.
Apparently,
I'm Country.
I'm Kate. And you know me.
Like, look at, you don't have to look at the camera. You can like, look at each other as if we were like, as if we were just sitting there. I'm just gonna go sit right where I was because this is awkward. Tell me your favorite part of this week.
I liked our ranger on our
Gamel. Yes. Tell me more about Camille.
I think the Gamel and his glowy skin were my favorite parts of the week.
What?
Shantae liked the smell of his shampoo.
It did. His hair smelled great.
I jumped in sharp.
Tell me more about shark cage diving. Did you almost die?
We
I
could
did.
have.
No, I didn't.
Could have, but
Fun
you
fact.
didn't.
Oh my gosh!
Rip.
It's not the rice. It's
What?
not the rice.
It's the milk.
It's the milk.
What did you do?
I've been.
Oh my gosh, have I been drinking expired milk?
Ew.
Best used by June 21st?
Oh.
Oh my god. Update. I have cereal since I got here, and I thought it was the cereal that was gross, but I've been
It's not the brownies.
It's not the brownies.
It's not the brownies.
okay, what's the part? I'm just gonna eat a Christmas.
Oh, I forgot. It's like Rice Krispies. It's like that type of. Oh.
You don't smell milk before you drink.
Oh.
Oh.
Let me smell it.
My okay, God. No, don't want to smell. Just
it out. Oh.
I don't think I want to smell it.
I know.
I can't smell it.
It's not that bad.
I can't smell. She can't smell.
You're
mine.
You're sick.
Did it, nothing? Oh my God, I'm so upset.
That's frustrating.
I cannot. It's been literally 5 days.
Life lesson learned.
Okay.
Keep refrigerated at below 4 degrees Celsius and use within expiration.
I didn't even don't know Celsius. That's why
it was. It says use within 3 days once opened. This much milk in 3 days.
A family?
Yeah.
That is God.
Why don't you smell your milk?
Why? Poll. Okay, poll for my viewers. How many of you smell your milk before?
Okay, it depends on the video. It's like between 3 and 106. I don't know.
Oh.
One of my videos got 106 views and I still don't know why. Also, people think
it's
I was just going to dispose of it all
down the sink.
Just hot water running down the sink.
Yeah, exactly.
I just think there's a chance they will spill it on our table here.
What? Kate's gonna... Kate, keep it in your mouth.
she started going. Literally, I was waiting. I was waiting. And Steve was like, okay, guys, let's go. And he's like, off, right? But here, she's literally next to my girl. And she, like, can't get her foot on the pedal.
Kristen.
Poor Kristen.
Run the Kristen cage. And then they start falling over.
And then everyone behind
them
is like.
Then they, like, went back a little and hit me. And then I had to, like, scrape Gwen's leg. And we're all, like, falling. And I was like, I can't be here. So
I
just
went to the process. I can't be here.
So I'm not going to be able to go.
I can barely touch it.
Oh, you'll be fine.
Dry cereal? Well, I'm sorry. I didn't realize Saint was in the room. You're even worse. What's worse, Satan or Lucifer? Because you're the worst one. How do I?
There's Beelzebub.
You need to read the expiration date.
I literally
lesson
learned.
Lesson
learned. Wow.
Kind of like is Angela from
Akron?
Is
she from?
Wait, where does she work from?
I don't know anything about
Akron. Where
does
she get a discount?
How 50%?
I think it's just half off.
No.
Oh, okay.
Half
okay.
Off. Just half off. But like, thank you so much for being the guest on my blog.
How much do you get off of here, Bradley?
If you guys are ever in Akron,
hey viewers, if you're ever in Akron,
I work at the Beer Bradley's on the mall.
I don't
know a lot of hours because
oh
I'm seasonal, but I won't be there for a week next month because I'm going on vacation. But if you're there before August,
but also don't ever visit.
Okay, everyone say goodbye.
Haley,
can't